The world marks a sight-saving month this August. Let's talk about basic eye care tips and early detection of eye diseases. We are joined by Dr. Leo Jubilian, an ophthalmologist and researcher at the Philippine Eye Research Institute. Dr. Leo, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you and good afternoon, Denise.
Now, Doc, cataracts and glaucoma are usually the most common eye conditions. You know, could you explain how these develop?
Oh, so the cataract is the number one cause of visual impairment in the Philippines, and it accounts to around a million Filipinos, and around 300,000 of them would require surgery. Cataract is really the aging of the lens of the eye, and it happens with age, and also it's accelerated when you have diabetes, and also with sun exposure. So when the lens, which is normally crystal clear, becomes opaque, so that's when you develop a visual impairment, and later on you might need a cataract surgery. Glaucoma, on the other hand, these patients would have elevated eye pressure, which can cause a damage to the nerve of the eye or the optic nerve, and we give medications or surgeries to reduce the eye pressure to prevent blindness or to prolong the eyesight of these patients.
Are there any other common eye diseases aside from cataract and glaucoma that you find Filipinos are very much prone to, I guess, with their lifestyle?
Yeah, well, error of refraction is one. In fact, we have a Republic Act that mandates vision screening among children when they are in the kindergarten. So it's passed into law recently, and the teachers would have this pass-fail test. No, it's like an image where they with figures they show to the children, which so to do a screening test. So if they pass the screening, that means they could see the blackboard. If not, we label them as a front row children. So they are placed in the front row of the classroom so they could see the blackboard. And it has been shown that it would increase their, improve their learning in school while waiting, also because the Department of Health is working on provision of eyeglasses to these children. Also, there are cases where they have lazy eye, especially in cases where one eye would have a high grade, no, than the other eye. And for it to be able to, so to prevent lazy eye, the good eye is patched a few hours a day so that the bad eye will be forced to see and develop vision when they are less than 7 years of age. So that's why the target is when they enter kindergarten, because they are around 5 or 6 years of age.
Doc, how can we do prevention for cataracts, for glaucoma, for eye refraction, for lazy eye? Because you mentioned also, of course, was the solution to these things. There's surgery, the eye patch that you just mentioned a while ago. But how about to prevent before it comes to that?
Right. There's a worldwide increasing prevalence, or there are more people with nearsightedness. No, they have high grade. We call it high myopia, and it has been shown that to prevent progression of the grade now among children during elementary school, we advocate for outdoor exposure or exposure to bright mainly outdoor exposure, because the lights that are inside the classroom is not enough, you know, to make the growth of the eye normal. So in the Philippines, error of refraction is around 8.9% at kindergarten. Then when they're in high school, it's already around 16 to 20 to 30%. And majority of these are nearsightedness. So if we are able to expose children to outdoor lights, the progression of this is controlled so that they will not develop blindness in the future. So what we do, the recommendation is around 3 hours per week. So we have collaborated with Department of Education, and so they are now allocating 2 hours of lessons in outdoor setting so that they are exposed to outdoor lights.
Doc, digital eye strain is also now a modern concern due to increased screen time. I guess what practical tips can you offer to mitigate this and also to maintain comfortable vision while still using our digital devices?
Yes, Denise, so for the digital eye strain, because most of us, when we are looking at our monitor or our cell phone, you blink less often, and in a way your eye gets could develop digital eye strain. So what we recommend, we have the 20-20-20 rule, meaning that you have every 20 seconds you take a break. For every 20 minutes you take a break for 20 seconds by looking at the 20 feet away. So that's the natural position of the eye. You're most relaxed when you look far. So that's what we ask patients to follow. And also when you are in your laptop, the level, the top of your monitor should be below your eyesight level so that you are looking down, so your eye is not as open as it should be, so that there's less dryness to the eye.
Do anti-blue light glasses work, Doc?
Well, theoretically, blue light from digital, from gadgets, because of this spectrum of light, it is the most, the highest energy, and it can, theoretically, it can damage the center of the vision. And so, although it's difficult to prove, but because we have ways to block the blue light, we recommend it, with screens, no, and your phones, there's a setting where you have a blue light filter, so that but it makes your screen a bit yellowish, and in a way, so you prevent the blue light. And of course, you can just do that without having to wear those anti-radiation or blue filter eyeglasses.
Dr. Leo Lassi, how can people take care of their eyesight to prevent any eye conditions?
Well, the best way for eye care is really there are stages in your life where you need the screening, and also conditions where you need screening. So sometimes some patients with condition who are premature, we screen for retinopathy of prematurity. This is a condition majority of our children in blindness school have. Then of course when you have error of refraction or myopia, outdoor exposure around 3 hours per day, around 15 hours per week, so to prevent progression. And when you're an adult, when you're 40, we screen for glaucoma, and 60 we screen for cataract. And in patients with diabetes, yearly we screen the back of your eye to make sure that you don't have the complication of diabetes, which can cause blindness. At the back of the eye, you can have like hemorrhages, and you need to be treated, not to prevent blindness. Doctor. In the future, actually, this is the area where researches are done. We have the artificial intelligence, where we have machines that when they check your eye for those with diabetes, the image of the eye is sent to, for example, in the Philippine Eye Research Institute, It would be evaluated whether you need an eye check by your doctor, or you can wait for one more year because it's a yearly checkup. So those are the things that would help to prevent blindness.
Doc Leo Cobelian, ophthalmologist and researcher at the Philippine Eye Research Institute. Doc Leo, thank you so much for your thoughts and insights.
Thank you, Denise. Good afternoon.